Hello guys, welcome to our channel Shubhada Group of Education CC. You are watching Satish Sir's physics videos for KCET and NEET. Here is a problem from moving charges and magnetism. The question says that a rectangular coil of length 0.12 meter and width 0.1 meter having 50 turns of wire is suspended vertically in a uniform magnetic field of strength 0.2 Weber per meter square. The coil carries a current of 2 ampere. If the plane of the coil is inclined at an angle of 30 degree with the direction of the field, the torque required to keep the coil in the stable equilibrium will be. Correct? So that's the reason they are asking the question for torque. As you know, the torque tau is equal to m into b into sine theta, and theta is the angle between the magnetic dipole moment as well as the magnetic field. Please try to remember that. Okay, so here, as we need to calculate the value of the torque, the magnetic moment is nothing but N into I into A. So B is as usual and it is a sine theta. Correct? So the number of turns is given. How much is the number of turns here? The number of turns is 50 turns here. And the current is given by how much it is? Current is 2 ampere current. And the area is nothing but length into width. So the length is 0.12 meter. And 0.1 meter is the width here, and this is the meter square. And after that, so how to find out the theta? So theta is nothing but here, the coil carries 2 ampere current, and if the plane of the coil is inclined at an angle of 30 degree with the direction of the field, suppose assume that it is the direction of the field, then the plane is inclined 30 degree. Correct? So plane is inclined 30 degree, so they say this is 30 degree with the so this is what, a 30 degree with the plane. Now so the theta is the angle between what, actually the magnetic dipole moment m as well as magnetic field. So suppose the angle between the plane of the coil as well as the magnetic field is 30 degree, then the angle between magnetic dipole moment as well as magnetic field is going to be how much? 60 degree it is. Correct? Clear? So this is going to be 60 degree. So that's the reason why theta is 60 degree. Now substitute the values. Torque tau is equal to the magnetic dipole moment m is nothing but NIA. It is what, 50 into 2 ampere current into 0.12 into 0.1 into what? The magnetic field B is how much? The B is given by 0.2 Weber per meter square, that is what, Tesla, into sine 60. Sine 60 is nothing but root 3 by 2. So suppose if you solve this, you will get 20784 Newton meter. So that's the reason why option A is the right answer for this question. Okay, so here the taking the direction is very much important, as if you take the theta is 30 degree, you will get the wrong answer here. Okay, the next problem says that a square loop ABCD carrying a current I is placed near and coplanar with a long straight conductor XY carrying a current I. The net force on the loop will be, so now this is what I here. Okay, let me use different color to solve this problem. This is a what I. So I current flows like this. This is what I here, I, and this is what I. Clear? So as this direction is opposite here, and the force experienced by them must be equal to zero. So because the force, say this is FBC and this is FAD, both are opposite. That's the reason why the resulting force between FBC and FAD is going to be zero. Okay, but what about this one? This is what, as the currents are in the same direction, that says they must be attract each other. So this is what the force on BA or AB, and this is what the opposite direction. So that's the reason why it must be repel each other. Correct or not? So repel each other, in the sense it will be like this. This is what force on CD. Okay, so as FABA as well as FD are in opposite direction, we need to subtract them. Correct? So let's try to get that FAB or FBA. FBA equal to, okay, so this is what, mu naught divided by 4 pi into 2 times IAIB, that is I into I divided by 2 pi D. This is what D, right? D is now, this is how much? So this is what, L by 2 now, L by 2, and force on CD is equal to mu naught divided by 4 pi into 2 times IAIB, this is same, I into I divided by, now the distance is L by 2 plus L, that is what, 3L by 2, correct? This is what, 3L divided by 2. Okay, let's try to subtract them. Force on BA minus force on CD, take the magnitude of them. Mu naught, this is what, 2, 2 gone, 2 ones are 2, 2s are, 2 ones are 2, 2s are like this. Okay, I and I are common in both the cases. Okay, so that's the reason why. Let me take them common here. Mu naught divided by 2 pi, mu naught 2 pi into I common. So this is what, 2 divided by L minus 2 divided by 3L. Okay, so how much will you get here? So mu naught divided by 2 pi. This is what, I into how much it is, 3, 6 minus 6 minus 2L, that is what, 2L divided by 3 times L square, 1L gone. So what we left with, so now I left with, this is what, 4L, sorry, 2 pi, 2 ones are, 2s are here. So left with how much, 2 times mu naught I into L divided by how much it is, 3 times pi, correct? So this is the reason why 2 times mu naught I into L divided by 3 pi. So that's the reason why option C is the right answer for this particular question. Move to the next problem here. An electron is moving in a circular orbit of radius r, makes n rotations per second. Okay, n rotations per second. So that's the reason why. So as you know that period is nothing but time period t is nothing but 1 divided by n. Now 1 rotations in 1 second, it can revolve n revolutions, correct? That's the reason why the magnetic field produced at the center will be, clearly I told you that magnetic field at the center due to the circular orbit is nothing but mu naught divided by 4 pi into theta I divided by radius r. Theta is nothing but 2 pi here, correct? Theta is nothing but 2 pi. So this is my 2 pi. This is the 2 pi now. 2 pi ones are, 2 twos are here. Mu naught divided by 2 into I is nothing but I divided by R now. There is no option of I in the options, correct? So this is why you need to replace I in the as charge on the electron. As soon as the charge is nothing but charge, or else let me take the current here. Current is nothing but charge per time. So the charge on the electron is E, and the time is how much it is, 1 divided by N. This is why N into E. So I can replace it as N E mu naught times N into E divided by 2R. Okay, so this is option C is the right answer for this question. Okay, so three wires are situated at the same distance. Okay, so let me take the distance as now is D here. Okay, D, let me take D here. Okay, so these wires in the same direction, what is the ratio of F1 to F2, where F1 is the force on F1 and F2 is the force on 2. Okay, so let's try to solve this problem now. Okay, so as the direction is same in all the three cases, correct? So that's the reason why if the direction is same, the conductors will be attracting each other, correct? So since they attract each other, so it will be like this, and this direction will be like this. This is what, let me take A, B, C. This is what, force on A due to B, and this is what, force on A due to C here. Okay, both are attracting each other. Okay, so that's the reason why, as you know that the force on A must be equal to force on A due to B plus force on A due to C here. Okay, so mu naught divided by 4 pi into 2 times IAIB, correct? IAIB, that is what, 1 into 2 divided by, distance is D now. Okay, distance is D. So plus FAC mu naught divided by 4 pi into 2 into IA into IC now. IA, 1 into 3 divided by, the distance is D plus D, that is what, 2D here. Okay, so which is the common term? Please try to take that. Mu naught divided by 4 pi into 2 divided by D is common. So what we left with here? 2 + 3, right? Whether it is 3 or 3 by 2. So now what is that? What we left with? 3 by 2 is left here. 3 by 2 is left, right? 3 by 2. Okay, so finally we left with how much it is? This is what mu naught divided by 4 pi into 2 divided by d into 7 by 2. 2 2's are 4. 4 plus 3 is 7. Yes, exactly 2. Now 2 gone. We left with 7 mu naught divided by 4 pi d. 4 pi d. Okay. So this is the first case now. Let's try to find out this is what a force on A now. Okay. So we need to calculate the value of force on B as well. Now here, as you take the directions here, the force on B, both are attracting each other. So both are attracting each other like this, and they must be like this. So as force on B due to A, this is what force on B due to C, both are in the opposite direction. This is, you know, we need to subtract them. Okay, so let's try to subtract them. Not how much it is, 1 into 2 here, it is 7 by 8 exactly. A is the right answer for this particular question. Move to the next problem. Force on B is equal to force on B due to A plus force on B due to C, right? So look at the directions. Okay, this is what mu naught divided by 4 pi into 2 times IA into IB, B into A, that is 1 into 2 divided by distance is D, minus, let me take here, because both are in the opposite direction, it must be minus here, okay, minus mu naught divided by 4 pi into 2 times IA into IB. The BC is how much? It is 2 into 3 now, divided by distance is, again, it is D only. Okay, so the mu naught divided by 4 pi into 2 is common, divided by D is also common. What we left with? 2 minus 6, right? 2 minus 6. D is common there. Okay, so what we left with here? Mu naught divided by 4 pi into... this is what 2 minus 6 is, it is minus 4, left with 8 here, 8, let me take the magnitude here, okay, FB magnitude, this is plus, it is plus 8 divided by D, 8 divided by D, okay. Is it correct? Yes, exactly, correct. So now take the ratio of them, F1, that is what, FA divided by FB, that must be equal to, what we left with, this must be 7 by 8. 7 by 8. So this is reason why option now. A conducting circular loop of radius R carries a constant current I. It is placed in a uniform magnetic field B naught such that B naught is perpendicular to the plane of the loop. This is a simple general problem. Suppose if it's the circular loop, at that time the magnetic field is perpendicular to it. Okay, at that time the force is always going to be zero, because force equal to B into I into L into sine theta. Correct. So you can either take sine theta, theta is 0 degree, okay, no problem for that, but due to diametrically opposite elements in the current carrying circular loops, the magnetic field or the resulting magnetic field as well as magnetic force is going to be zero on the loop. So this is my option C is the right answer for this question. Okay, move to the next problem. Now a charged particle with velocity 2 into 10 to the power of 3 meter per second passes undeflected through the electric and magnetic field. The magnetic field is 1.5 tesla. The electric field intensity would be, is the question. This is the question on velocity selector. In velocity selector, QVB must be is equal to Q into E. Okay, so that's the reason why what we'll have to do is E is equal to V into B. So now here V is going to be how much? 2 into 10 to the power of 3 and magnetic field is 1.5 tesla. So this is, it is 3 into 10 to the power of 3 newton per coulomb. This is my option C is the right answer for this question. The next problem says that a circular loop of area 0.02 meter square carrying a current of 10 ampere is held with its plane perpendicular to the magnetic field of induction 0.2 tesla. The torque acting on the loop is, again, it is going to be how much? Zero only. Again, it is going to be zero only here, because I clearly told you that when the magnetic field is going to be perpendicular to the plane at that time, the torque is going to be zero. Okay, there is no deflection. It has to make some angle with the plane of the loop. Okay. The next problem, an electron moves in a circular arc of radius. Radius is given as how much? 10 meter. At a constant speed, V is given by 2 into 10 to the power of 7 meter per second, with its plane of the motion normal to the magnetic field intensity of 10 to the power of minus 5 Tesla. What will be the value of the electric charge, specific charge of the electron? See, look at the units here. This is charge per kg. Charge and coulomb per kg, in the sense it is they are expecting the answer as charge per mass equal to how much. As you know that mv divided by qb equal to how much, radius r, it implies charge per mass, that must be equal to charge per mass v divided by b into r. Okay, so therefore charge per mass must be equal to velocity is how much, speed is 2 into 10 to the power of 7 divided by magnetic field strength is 10 to the power of minus 5 into how much, the radius is how much, radius is given as 10 here, 10 here. That's the reason it is 2 into 10 to the power of 11, right? 11 coulomb per kg. Option D is the right answer. Okay, the next problem is, a solenoid of length 1.5 meter and 4 centimeter diameter possesses a turn, 10 turns per centimeter. Okay, so the length is not required and the diameter is also not required, as it is independent. Magnetic field is independent of the length as well as diameter, mu naught ni, number of turns per unit length, and current I is the current here. So mu naught is how much, it is 4 pi into 10 to the power of minus 7. Okay, into the number of turns is 10 turns per centimeter, and the current is how much, it is current is given as 5 ampere current. Okay, so that's the reason why it is 2 pi into 10 to the power of minus 5 Tesla is the right answer, option D. The next problem is, a current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field experiences maximum force when the angle between them is, it's a general problem, it is what, pi by 2. As you know that F is equal to I into L cross B, right? L cross B. So it is nothing but I into L into B into sine theta. Sine theta is maximum when theta is equal to pi by 2. So that's why option B, pi by 2 is the right answer. The next problem is, two concentric circular coils of 10 turns each are situated in the same plane. Their radii are 20 and 40 centimeter. They carry the respectively 0.2 and 0.4 ampere current in the opposite directions. The magnetic field Weber in the center is the question, right? As you know that the currents are in the opposite direction, we need to subtract them. The B must be equal to mu naught divided by 4 pi into theta I divided by R is the actual expression to find out the magnetic field on the circular loop at the center, correct? So the net magnetic field must be equal to, there are two different coils, okay, in the which are carrying the current in the opposite direction. That's the reason why mu naught divided by 4 pi is constant and theta is 2 pi is constant in both the cases. Now I is how much, in the first case it is 0.2 divided by R1 is how much, 20 centimeter, 20 into 10 to the power of minus 2 minus 0.4 divided by 40 centimeter, 40 into 10 to the power of minus 2. Okay, so now 20, it is, I have to multiply by 2. 0.2 into 2 is how much, 40. So 0.4 minus 0.2 is going to be how much, 0. This term is going to be 0. That's the reason why the net magnetic field is going to be 0. Option D is the right answer for this question. The next problem is, an electron mass is given, the charge is also given, moving with the velocity 10 to the power of 6 meter per second, enters the magnetic field. If it describes circle of radius r, then the strength of the magnetic field will be, it is, you know, the mv divided by qb equal to radius r. The mass is 9 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kg and the speed is 10 to the power of 6 divided by, the charge is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb into magnetic field is how much, the magnetic field strength is to be calculated, and the radius is given by how much, it is 0.1 meter. Only B is unknown. If you calculate this one, B equal to 5.5 into 10 to the power of minus 5 Tesla. Option C is the right answer for this question. Okay, the next problem, that is the last problem here. A current of 3 ampere is flowing the linear conductor having the length 40 centimeter. The conductor is placed in a magnetic field of strength 5500 gauss. Okay, makes an angle of 30 degree with the direction of the field. It explains the force of magnitude is how much. Okay, you know that the force F equal to I into L into B sine theta. Now the magnetic field strength is given by 500 gauss. 500 gauss is given here. Okay, as the magnetic field is in terms of the gauss, I need to multiply it by 10 to the power of minus 4 to convert it into Tesla. Into the current is how much? 3 ampere current into L. The length of the conductor is 40 centimeter. 40 into 10 to the power of minus 2. The sine 30 is going to be 1 by 2. And that is going to be 1 by 2. Okay. So what we left with here? Suppose if you solve this one, 20 gone. We left with 3 into 10 to the power of minus 2 Newton. Okay. So option B is the right answer for this particular question. So thank you very much for watching this video. Please do subscribe to our channel. Please share this channel with your friends, colleagues, and to support us. And if you have any doubts, just make a comment on the comment box so that I can help you with. Thank you very much and wish you all the best for your examinations. Bye.